Well, Nigel Fox is editor of the leading motoring consumer journal, Motoring Witch, who make a point of examining and reviewing and testing the various locks on all the cars that they consumer test. Nigel, what are your findings in this area?
I think they're pretty depressing. We burgle the cars without actually damaging them. We don't throw bricks through the window to get into them. We find in our tests that we can get into about 40% of the cars in under 5 seconds, about 70% in under 10 seconds. And of the ones that take a little bit longer, we can get into nearly all of them. There are very few cars that we can't get into given a few minutes.
It's really that easy?
Oh, it's very easy indeed.
Well, we have a fairly popular sort of car here, a Ford Escort. Perhaps you could go over and lock the driver's door. And then we could ask your resident car thief researcher, I should say, to come along, Malcolm Osborne, and just see whether he can get in and how long it takes him to do so. The door is locked with the key, and there's the door open again. My goodness, that's rather depressing. How about putting things in the boot? You obviously get into the inside fairly easily. We're all told to put things out of sight in the boot.
Right.
How about that?
Putting things in the boot is a good idea, as you say, because they are out of sight. This car needs the key to open the boot, in theory. Malcolm can usually open it without the key, without much difficulty.
Heavens, and away goes all the valuable shopping.
Right.
As far as the standard locking equipment is concerned, which manufacturer have you found is the worst offender?
Well, it would be easier to say which wasn't the worst offender, really, because so many of them do so little to protect at least the contents of the car. The only maker whose cars we've consistently had great difficulty burgling is Saab.
Sometimes the thief doesn't have to go to all that much trouble. You see, it seems we make it very easy for the car thief. We leave our cars with the doors unlocked, the keys in the ignition, the windows down. Very easy indeed. So we came to Brent Cross, one of those big new shopping centres here in North London, specially designed for the motorist who wants to bring his car to the shops to see how careful these motorists have been. And to help us in that endeavour, we have with us Inspector Maurice Parsons, who's one of the crime prevention officers from Scotland Yard. Maurice, surely the great British public aren't that bad, are they?
You would think not, but if you care to come along this row of cars with me and just check, we'll see how good they are.
All right, we'll put it to the test. Mercedes? Well, so,
that's fine. That's
all
fine.
Right.
It's well locked.
Nice new P registration Passat there.
Yes, well, that's, if you look at the passenger door,
yeah, the button's
appears
up,
to be open. The button's up, yes. That's open.
Now, here's a nice bit of machinery.
Nice car, yes, very nice. Left equipment inside in full view.
Lots of cassettes in there.
I think if you check that back door.
Hello.
Open.
It's a gift, isn't it? What about the boots? Do people lock the boots?
People often forget the boots. Because they're closed, they appear locked.
But a few bobs worth in there as well, isn't there?
Quite a few. And probably carrying a representative carrying goods.
Here
this one, again,
try the boot again,
probably find that it's open. Yes?
Yes, it is.
Not much in there, but if you look at the door on
this... Oh, that is classic, isn't
that
it?
Is,
that is just
yes.
Beautiful. I mean, why bother to have a door, frankly?
There's a nice coat in the back and a kiddie's coat as well.
Nice fur coat, yes. Maurice, what percentage of thefts are involved where the car is taken away, as opposed to the percentage of thefts where things are taken out of the car? Do we know?
Well, a lot of the cars that are taken away, in fact, have property stolen from them. There are about 50,000 cars that weren't moved last year that had property stolen from them, and about 70,000 cars were actually taken. But a lot of those had probably stolen from them as well.
So even if you got your car back, the fur coat might be missing?
Yes,
right.
No doubt it would be.
Who does this? Are we talking about professional car thieves or joyriders or opportunists or what?
The majority, and probably about 75%, are the chap that we call the opportunist, the man who just walks around a car park such as this, looking for this opportunity to open the door, take something quickly and go away.
Would an anti-theft device put him off?
In the majority of circumstances, yes.
But the professional thief, would what would put him off? Better locking, I suppose, in the first place.
Better locking and a complete integrated security system on the vehicle what is needed.
Which most cars don't have.
Very few cars have.
Why then can't the lock manufacturers make cars more difficult to crack? That's a question we shall be putting to the biggest suppliers of car locks in Great Britain in just a moment.
Welcome back. With me is Alan Norman, who's engineering director of Britain's largest car lock manufacturers, Wilmer Breeden. Alan, we've seen how simple it is to break into a car, and considering it's our second most expensive possession, it seems quite stupid to have such a small lock on it. What are you, the manufacturers, doing about it?
Well, we originally had that device, which is a very simple one with only five wards.
Now, why do you use a small lock like that?
Because we haven't got a lot of space within the door to fit a locking device.
And what would you need if you need a more secure lock?
You'd need one with more wards, like this one, which has 10 wards.
But that, of course, will protrude into the door and stop the window coming down. So what are you doing?
So we've devised a simple one which has 5 wards each side, giving the security of the 10 ward, but in a much smaller space.
How much more secure is that one above that one?
Well, my tame locksmith can pick that one in 12 minutes and pick that one in about 30 seconds.
Well, surely then, this is the one that car manufacturers should be leaping at. What are their problems?
Their problems are it's slightly larger, so they would have to do a modification to the door, and they prefer to do that when they're doing a new model.
It's not a cost problem?
The cost penalty is not very large, being some 10 to 15p per device.
Now, the last time this question of security cropped up was with the steering lock, and manufacturers weren't all that keen to fit a steering lock. What made them change their minds?
Legislation, government-proposed legislation, helped them to make up their mind to do it.
Is it going to be the same answer here? They're going to need a little persuasion to put this sort of lock in?
They will need a lot of persuasion, I would think, to put that in.
Well, do you think at least they could be persuaded to get rid of those little pop-up door buttons, because we've seen how vulnerable they are?
Well, yes, they can certainly be persuaded to do that. In fact, on the new Rover, they have a rocking lever, which is much less susceptible to burglaring.
And it's hidden away?
And it's hidden away.
Thank you very much, Alan. Well, obviously, it's almost impossible to protect the car from the really determined car thief. But we on Drive-In do think that the manufacturers could do a great deal more about it. Let's face it, to pay £5,000 for a car and then have it broken into in a matter of seconds, we consider is nothing short of scandalous.